Hey everybody, this is a live, very impromptu stream. I just got a wild hair and decided I'm going to come down here and play. So, I don't know if anybody's online yet or will be online because this was literally last minute. Gotta mute myself there. So anyway, those of you who are watching this on YouTube, this was a live stream recording. If you hear me talking to anybody, that's the broads in the box. They're on the chat with me. Occasionally we get a gentleman or two that join us. Hey, Brenda. Thanks for retweeting. This was like a last minute, like, am I going to go? Yeah, let's go. So with no plan ahead or anything. So anyway, if you'd like to join us live for the stream sometime for the YouTubers, you can join us at ustream.tv and search for the channel Inky Obsessions and follow me. And then whenever I go live, you'll be alerted that I'm going live. So, hey, Colleen. Anyway, the other night I played with these colorful tags where I was experimenting with pardon me, some Dina Wakely paints, and I was playing in my journal with some Dylusions paints, and I didn't really do much with those. I just sort of blended them out on a page, but look at those colors. Oh my gosh. So Paula said something to me the other day about, she mistakenly thought that Jean said that I played on the jelly plate with my Dylusions paint. But it was my Dina Wakely paints that I put on the jelly plate. But then I thought, oh, let me try the Dylusions on my jelly plate. So I just started thinking about that today. Hey, guys. Hey, CB. CB Alicia. So I am totally out of control down here. Not set up at all. I've got a little bit less than 2 hours. Dave said, well, let's, if you want to stream, go stream. We'll put off our dinner until later. Just going to throw some burgers on the grill tonight for something quick. But these are some of the tags I played with before the stream, just on my own. And then these I did in the stream the other day. This one doesn't look that great, but when you see it, when it catches that gold and a little bit of pictograph sticking out there, it's kind of cool. And I love this one. Love those colors. And that silver. The metallics, the Dina's metallics really pop. So anyway, that's what I thought I'd do. And I might mix some up because I still got all the paints laying out here. So I'm going to push these back, give myself a little elbow room. Get out my jelly plate. You know, maybe I ought to exchange this piece of paper here so it's not interfering with the view. Put this over on the side. Got a lot of yummy on there. All right, hang on. Let me get some elbow room here. I tell you, I like to fly by the seat of my pants. I'm telling you, no plan. I got no plan. I got nothing. Grab some cardstock. Grab some deli. And we'll see what happens. Yeah, Brenda, they're really nice, vibrant colors. I really like them. Well, you can plan on Diane doing nice, vibrant colors. Although I think she's got some, a couple little more neutral colors coming out, which you kind of have to blend those into each palette, I guess. But you can always count on Diane for those bright colors. And I've had classes in person with both Diane Reevely and Dina. A lot of fun, really talented girls. And love their classes. So let me put this here, find my stencils. I'm telling you, totally discombobulated. It seems to be how I function lately. If you'd see my desk, I've got a pile over here from when I was doing all those cigar boxes. I've got piles here from the Mike's tag experiment the other day. Nice. So let me, I'm going to grab a couple 8x10 stencils. Oh, my new stencils are going to be coming out soon. So, as soon as I hear from Sherry, I'll start throwing some information out there for you guys. All right, that ought to be enough to get me started, huh? I'm anxious to see how these layer. They're so translucent and they blend so well. So I'm really anxious to see how these roll out on the jelly plate. And if when I do layers, a pull on top of a pull, if they're actually going to blend through. That's one thing I'm really curious about. And wouldn't that look cool if it did? So I am going to, hang on, I'm looking for a different brayer. Good night. Oh, there it is. Okay. Now I'll try this. I'm not sure how this is going to work for me. And I might switch up and just do a smaller jelly plate to play with these when it comes down to it. But I was watching a Carol Doobie video the other day, and she was dipping her little brayer. I think she might have had a 2-inch one. No, it must have been this one because a 2-inch one wouldn't fit. Actually, maybe that is 2 inches. It is. Must have been this one. So, she was dipping it right in the jar. So, let's see what we get. And I'm going to open them up. And if they dry out, then they dry out. But I'm not going to... I've seen people using them online where they... put the lid on between each little dip of the paint. I'd end up shooting myself if I had to do that. Not gonna do that. If I get a little scum layer of dry on there, I'll pull it off like it's pudding. Okay, look at that little rainbow. I don't have all of Diane's. I only have these, started out with these 6, but they're all my favorite colors that I use a lot, so. We shall see. All right, I'm gonna dip and go. Wow, look at that color. It's a little brighter in person. I'm gonna run my brayer on my paper because I don't want to contaminate the jar of color. And I'm gonna go with some yellow. I'm gonna take a little bit more of that off because that was a lot of paint. Now I probably don't have enough. But I just want to get in here and get some of that orange blend going. Makes a really pretty orange color. Coral almost with that hot pink in the... Oop. Just keeps changing colors. I love it. All right, let me grab something. Here's this first one. This is pyramid. I don't know why I call this pyramid. It's not triangular, but I guess a pyramid really is square, right? It just goes up like a cone. Oh, yeah, that's why I called it pyramid, because it is a pyramid. Hey, Robin. Hey, Bunny. Glad you guys could join last minute. I know it's kind of a free-for-all, but that's the way I live anymore. So I'm using Dylusions paints on the jelly plate. It really is a cool stencil, Colleen. It's very graphic and linear. So when you overlay that with some of the more organic or round curvy lines, it's kind of a cool striking. Hello, lover. Ooh, look how sketchy that looks around here. Where that line got real thin in there. Now that's kind of thick. That's a good amount of paint on there. Good grief, where am I going to set these to dry? I'm going to pull another one. There's still enough paint on there for another pull. Now if you guys see me using these stencils, these are all my eye stencils, but don't go out and buy them yet because we got a sale coming up and a new release with some new designs. So go put some of you want in your shopping cart, but don't check out until you get my next coupon code. Trying to help you out. Ooh, even nicer. That's pretty. I mean, I still got some more on there. You know what? I think I'm going to pull this just to get all this off of there. So I get a clean print on the reverse design. Yeah, you could, Colleen. That's even kind of cool, where it fades out to the bottom. It's hard to screw up a jelly print when you got a nice paint and a nice design. All right, I'm going to take this, and look at that yummy. I don't know if you guys can see that coral color that's right about there. It's really pretty. It's not orange in person. It's very bright coral. One thing I like to do is if I'm going to use the 8x10 jelly plate, and obviously it's smaller than the paper, right? We all know that. And you know, I cannibalized one of my first big 12x14. I cut it down to 8.5x11, so I get a full print. But when I demo stuff, I like to use the one everybody else has, the 8x10, and not throw them off by, like, why aren't my prints all coming out to the edge of the paper? But what I do is, when I'm doing this, I reach with these fingers underneath the paper, and before I put the paper down, I feel where the jelly plate is, so I can try to get it somewhat centered. Where is Eileen? I'm surprised anybody's here, to tell you the truth. I decided to come on approximately 10 minutes ago, I think. Ooh, look at that. That's cool. I like this wavy texture over here where it sucks some of that paint off and got that little shadowy, ripply effect. And I still have more. You know what I'm going to do? Grab a piece of deli. I think the deli will pull that off. And you know what? I have my... I'm going to grab this and just lay it down here to get some of that off the back of my stencil. It's still on there. Oops. Schmutzed that around, didn't I? This paint's just going and going and going. Still have more on there. And I really didn't use that much. This really does. And I've heard other people say that it's really, it extends. I mean, it just goes and goes and goes. Oh, it kind of got a see-through print, kind of a shadow there. Hey, deboring. My arm and my chair's loose. I think the screw's almost out of it. If you hear a big crash and don't see me on screen anymore. Somebody call 911. Probably snuffed it. Okay, let's see. Now, what do I want to do for a second layer on this? I think this might look cool. And what do I want to do for color? Let's go with... green and turquoise. I mean, how can we go bad there? But I'm not going to use as much paint this time. And I'm really curious to see if this is going to give me some purple and greens over that pink and yellow. I guess I can test it here too, if it's going to do that. Grab me a little bit of green. Hey, Cass! I might need a little bit more than that. Drag this over and try to get a little bit of a blend going here. This sprayer, I don't like the way this sprayer leaves the lines in the paint, honestly. Let's see if I get those edges dulled down there a little bit. Now this kind of blended with the pink that was on the plate. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. Got a little blendy with a little bit of the crusty bits that were left on there. All right, I'm going to use this one. This is Orb Stacks. And I really like this design. Sort of Michelin Tire Man-esque. All right, now I'm just gonna grab one of these. It looks like it's pretty dry. This was, I think, was a second pull, although that's not really that dry. And these are supposed to dry fast, but I did have a good amount of paint on there. This one definitely I can't use yet. You know what? The heck with it, I'm gonna go with this. So I'm gonna mindfully put the pink over the turquoise and the yellow over the green. So I'm in the same kind of color family, so I don't get a baby poop brown pull. All right. My one brayer, I used it so much it squeaked. It didn't matter what you did to it. I WD-40'd that baby. I try not to use that one when I stream. But then my new one, the replacement one, does the same thing. Okay, here we go. Let's see if we got any Blendo. Actually, I think it did a little bit. See where I got different shades of the turquoise? I don't know if that's showing up on camera that well. But it seems darker as it goes up, like it's getting us a little bit of that. And this, the green, seems to go lighter as it goes from here down. Can you tell that on camera? That's kind of cool how you see these stark circles that are white space with the white space of the lines behind it. That looks like one of those things you try to focus on and see dolphins in it or something when your eyes come into focus the right way. I like it. Me likey. Now there's not a whole lot here to pull up. I'm going to try it on this one, being mindful again to keep the pink on the turquoise and hope for purple if it does anything. I don't think there's very much on here, but I might get a little tiny ghost of these orbs on this one. Whoa. Yeah, not liking the looks of that one. I did get the ghost, but it doesn't really do this one any favors, I don't think. This is too funky. That doesn't grab me. This one's going to grab me, though. Right there. That one's going to grab me. Is this one ready to go over yet? You know what? It's still a little bit wet, but I'm going for it. And I'm going to clean this off on the back. Hey, Jean! Glad you caught me sneaking on. Yes, Colleen, thanks for tweeting, too. I am, Jean, remember when you told Paula, and she understood you to say that I used Dylusions on the jelly plate, but it actually was Dina Wakely's that I used on the jelly plate? I started thinking about it, and I thought, I gotta go try that. So these are Dylusions. Look, it put some pink down because this was still wet. Okay, not a fan. I liked it better before I did that to this one. But a little pop of black might still pull that back. Out of the three, this is my favorite. Okay, I'm going to take my little deli scrap here and try to pick some of this off of there. Hey, Jean, did you want... I had told, I think, most of the Canadian girls that are coming to Maryland, I've offered to order them a box of this deli paper that I like. That, like I sent you, Jean, the box I sent you, you probably have enough left. But that 1,000 sheet of the 12 by 12 with no crease in it, I was going to offer to do that for the Canadian girls so they can pick it up in Maryland and not have to pay to get it to Canada. That's painful. And just, it's $15.98 a box, I think. Just PayPal me the money and let me know that that's what you want me to do, and I'll be happy to get it. I'm not going to do the same. That sounds terrible, but I'm not going to do the same for the U.S. girls coming, because they can really do that on their own anytime they want to for the same price. And it's less I have to hump over to the place. So... yeah, I figured you did, Jean. All right, let's go a little purple. It goes on the plate kind of nice. Although, as I say that, it's beating up over here in this corner. Get that cleaned off my brayer, and I'm going to go with a little turquoise with this purple, because that's what I like. I'm starting out on the outer edge to keep this mostly turquoise, and then go for the blend as I get to go towards the center. Try to get a little blendy in there. Getting a little bit of a third color in there. I don't know if you guys can see that in this overlapped area with the glare. I'm not sure it shows up. It's subtle, but it is there. What's the brand name, Patty? Of the deli? Tammy, it's, what the hell is it? Quick Wrap. Q-W-I-K-R-A-P. Let's use this one. I haven't used this one in a while. This one was even made before I had names on them. So its name is number 20. Oh, you know what? This might have been a test one because this doesn't fit just right. This comes off my plate a little bit. So that might have been in the test batch. I get it from Sam's Online, Tam. We used to get 5 boxes of 1,000 sheets each for $15.98. And they must have caught on to how many people were ordering those 5 boxes. And now you can get 1 box of 1,000 for $15.98. And I even saw when I first ordered the 1 box, in the URL description, it still had a five box carton worded in the description. So they very clearly changed it. Yeah, that's kind of cool. You can see a little bit of the blend in there. Down here it's more of a, it almost looks like a bluey, not quite navy, but a darker blue where it blended. And I'm going to take my little cleanup sheet here and try to get some of this ghost out of there. This is nothing. This is just something I'm cleaning off the plate with. Although it may end up in something really cool, but it's doubtful at this point. So, look at you. Hello, lover. Yeah, kind of like a denim jean. Denim blue. Clean up my back of my stencil. You. Looks like it's got watermarks in it. See all these little like bubbly bits on there? I don't know why. Maybe something on my booger on my brayer or something. I don't know. That's all right. I can work with that. So what do I want to combine now? Let's do, you know what? I want to, these are so blendy. I don't want it to make mud when I'm putting different colors on here. That's my concern. I should just try it and see if it does, so I know that, instead of trying to just work around something I'm not even sure is going to happen. So let's just try it, shall we? I'm going to go green. Green for Jean. That ought to scare the heck out of you. Hey, Chessie girl. I'm trying to say the screen name of the one that was sitting down to do schoolwork. Blah Bataglia. I know there's another name in there somewhere, but hello, dear. I've seen your screen name before. That's so hard. I liked Dee Dee's idea about making a little Rolodex of all the people's screen names that follow her. Because I'm telling you, between Facebook, Twitter, and emails, and Ustream names, I don't know who the hell I am, let alone anybody else. This is blending a little bit, and it's not as, can you see that difference? It's picking up a little bit of that purple in the paint. So you can see when I put that down, the difference of from here where it did blend. It did blend with the color on the plate. So something to be mindful of if you want that cool crisp color as it comes out of the jar. It will blend with those little teeny tiny layers of shadows that are left on your plate from a pull. You know, the kind we like to pick up in a cleanup print. Now this had a little bit of turquoise under here, just a little bit. I'm going to see if this goes to the green side. Go to the green side. Some lemon lime. This is another damn squeaky brayer. All right. Oh, I didn't even think about what I'm doing here. Oop, need a stencil. Grab a stencil. Here we go. We'll use this one. I like this one too. This one is Shield Stacks. Who the hell will come up with these names? I don't know. All right, let's do a clean piece of card on here. Oop, did you see what happened? It shifted as I laid it down. I'm going to have a cockeyed print. Hey, Topaz! Hey, Pam, Mitzi. Thanks for joining on my impromptu play. Now you can see, well, this is cockeyed on here because, as I said, it slipped out of my hand when I put it down. But they aren't near as bright. You can see up here where I got a little brownish going on, just a brown tinge. It's still a green, but it's more olive, I guess, where I had shades of little shadows of purple up here on my plate. And you can see some of the blend going on here between the yellow and the green. Not bad, but it's still a lot of paint on there, actually. This paint really does go far, so be mindful if you're going to use it on your jelly plate that it doesn't take much. Hey, Vicky! Supplies! Had a wild hair and I thought I gotta go try those Dylusions paints on my jelly plate. But I can't do my, oops, I can't do my regular 3 hours. And Cass, what time do you normally go on? I know don't you usually do Fridays? I was trying not to clash with you. That's why I kind of just blasted down here and jumped on. Yeah, you can see a lot of that discoloration. It's the blended color. But it's not that hot lime green that you see there. Right? It did blend with what's left on the plate. So, as a rule, maybe we need to be mindful of that. And I'm just going to pick this up on here. And wipe the plate off in between if you want that clean color. Still got a good amount of paint down there. But I might need to leave that there. I wouldn't have thought these would work quite well on a jelly plate. Hey, Paige! Yeah, they seem to be working pretty well. It's just that blendability, which makes them what they are. I mean, they're awesome blendable paints. But I like the feel of the print when they dry. You almost can't feel it. It's slick. Not slippery slick. It's can barely feel where you can only feel the paint where it's thicker and kind of had that, I don't know if that'll show, maybe on the turquoise. You know where you get that little dimply ridge when you got too much paint on there? Probably not going to show in this camera. You guys know what I'm talking about. But they dry very, very smooth. This I can feel a little bit of texture because this was a good amount of paint. I got some of these little puckers on there. All right, let's see. What do I want to do? Something that's going to blend with yellow. So I'll stay in the warm family. Let's try to work it that way. Let's grab a couple different patterns here. Dig down a little deeper. All right, let's do something with this. Okay, look, I got like a rainbow over here on my palette I'm rolling off on. I'm going to use orange. Let's go a little bit of orange over this yellow. And if you want to blend, go ahead and blend because it's just going to make another pretty color. And I guess that's all you really need to be mindful of is just keep the warm colors together and the cold colors together. Because when you dip one into the other, if they are complementary colors, you're going to get mud. Let's put some hot pink in here. Hot pink. I love hot pink. That is hot pink too, man. My girl Diane's got her going on for these bright colors. I mean, you know what? I want to try some Dina on here too. I did Dina paints on the jelly plate just through her needle tips. But I'm going to try them right on the plate. Like I would usually use them on the plate. Really pretty coral in there. I could just do this all day. Of course, the squeaking makes me a little cuckoo. See that pretty coral color that rubbed off there? Kind of looks orange on the screen to me. You're probably not getting the real gist of it, but you can trust me. I would not lie about a pretty coral color. And I'm just going to use stripes. This seems like a silly stencil, but I love it. It's got so many uses. I use it a lot of times and just use like this little edge and sponge through it to put a little line of dashes down the side of a page or something. I like it. Yeah, the blends are really cool, Pearl. Hot pink. Love me some pink. Hey, look at you. Kind of looks like scrapbook paper now. But, in stark contrast, let's put it over this. See what we get with this ghost. I don't know if we'll get enough on there to make a decent print, but I'm gonna the old thumb knuckle down there and go in the direction of the holes of the design of the stencil. Oh, did you guys, speaking of stencils, do you guys see where Laurie Micah is now a stencil girl and came out with a bunch of border stencils? Love Laurie Micah. Kind of interesting. So now, let me get this little bit here. Is this dry? I'm gonna dry it on here. So I want to keep the yellow on the pink and the more orange on the, well, I don't know. Might get a baby poop print. Oh, you know what? I see somebody asking Kathy what time she streams, and I just realized I asked her a question then wasn't watching this screen, so I don't know if you answered me or not, Kathy. And when Kathy, when you go on, if we overlap at all, you guys that normally watch Kathy, please jump over there and watch her. Because I'm not going to be on very long tonight. And I don't want to try not to conflict with anybody. But if the way my schedule is, if I don't go when I can go, I don't get to go. Oh, you're switching to Tuesdays. Oh, okay. Yeah, that didn't do that one any favors. But a little pop of black might pull that one back. Back from the brink. Let me get my snotted up deli paper here. Ooh, that's a hot mess. Whoop. Good lord. think I might need another piece of that to try to get some of this off of there. But let's see. What do I want to do over here? Let's do, ooh, that's a lot of pink on there. Well, hell with it, let's go. I'm just gonna put turquoise and hit it on the pink side. We'll see what happens. I love being able to dip the little brayer right in the pan of paint. I don't like the little edges that it gives me streaks as I'm brayering. I like my paint to look real smooth when I brayer it. I know it's just more texture, but I don't know. I like my paint to be smooth and put in the texture I want to be in there. Squeaky, squeaky. Let's put a little yaller over here. See what kind of green we get in the middle. And it's yellow over yellow, so this shouldn't go too badly. But there's still a shade of this turquoise on the brayer, even though I brayered it off. It seems to be sticking to those edges. I'll try not to bring my squeaky brayers to class in Maryland when you guys come. It's a lot more rolling with this little brayer, for sure. Especially when you're trying to get it blended out. Alright. Pretty yellow green though. Okay. Oops, what am I using? Let's try this. This one, the Chevron. What do I call it? Oh, again, this is one of the earlier ones. This was called number 17. But I think I have named them since. This might have been out of the test batch for the first ones. Oh, that's a pretty good blend though. Can you see that green in there that came up? I think this is a 2-inch brayer, or inch and a half. I don't know. Let's see what this is. Inch and a half brayer. The caps are a little over 2 1/4, but at the widest point, they're almost 2 1/2. But you got to allow for that curve in there. But I guess there's probably a 2-inch brayer too. So let's see. I'm going to put the turquoise. I'm going to go against my instincts. Instead of going pink for the turquoise, I'm going to flip it and put the orange against the turquoise. Hope I don't get brown. Dirty hands getting all over the back of my pages. Hey, Joan, how are you? This one, you thought the other night was a last minute stream. This one is the last minute stream. I said to Dave, I think I'll go stream, and 5 minutes later I turned the camera on. But everybody, Minky5, that is my friend Joan, who sent me all those gorgeous papers and these cards. Two times now that she makes the, hang on, where did I put them? I hid them for myself to keep them safe. Remember all these from the other night I showed you guys in my Happy Mail? And she's actually got my artwork made on some of these papers in here. Remember all those? That's Minky5, my friend Joan from the UK. And sent me that and a bunch of other goodies. And she's the one that she was saying that you guys, she would love, you guys were saying you would love to have a class from her to show you how to use that software program. Oh, that's kind of stark and cool. Kind of Candy Striper meets Marquee Cinema Arrows or something. I don't know. Kind of makes you dizzy there, doesn't it? Woo, 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 woo. All right, let's see what I can do with this one. I don't want to put it on that green. Let me try this one. And let me flip this way. Let's see what I get out of this. Oh, you know what? I didn't open links up. Hang on, guys. I'll open up links. Hold your horses here. Okay, links are open. Yeah, this is another stencil that's not real fancy, but it makes a big impact on the design, and you kind of get a 3D effect out of it. I don't know if you guys can pick that up on camera. See the blend in that turquoise and the blend behind it in the orange to the pink? Really pretty blendy stuff here with these paints. And look, even my stencil's pretty now. Okay, I can see this wasn't a good decision. No. Hot mess there. I did myself no favors on that one. But that's okay. That's how we learn. And look at all this yellow. I like you, but I want to get rid of you because I don't want you interfering with my next pull so much. Okay, let's try one more combination. And then I think I'm going to switch and do some Dina paints on here. So let's just do it. I'm going to go turquoise and hot pink and see if they are the right turquoise and the right pink that make a pretty purple. I believe they will be because her original sprays, the first colors that came out, the turquoise in there and the bubblegum pink together make the most gorgeous purple. Okay, I'm going to clean this off so I don't contaminate my jar. But I think if I'm going to do this more often, I'm going to invest in a 2-inch brayer and get that extra half an inch, I think, will be a help. A little bit more view. A little bit. Oh, look at you, yummy. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Wow. That's pretty. Okay. Now, what can I do with you? Let's go some Greek key. That's got some yumminess. I want to use a real open stencil so we see all of that color that we can. This is brilliantly colored in person. I hope you guys can pick that up. Okay. I know, Topaz, when you're talking about the new stream notices not being consistent. I know, I never get a notice for Shannon Green, and I'm on her channel, and I don't think I've yet to catch her live. Well, I didn't press down the bottom, and that's too bad, because that's a cool print. Look at all that blending. You can see blending in each of the rows of the Greek key. Now that's pretty dang cool, if you ask me. I'm gonna try to get a ghost of this and push down on the whole freaking thing this time. Dumbass. Yeah, Joan, these are the Dylusions paints in the jars from Diane Reevely. She's in the UK with you. They come in these big pots of yumminess. There are a lot more colors. I just got 6. I think, I don't know how many she's got. 12, I think. I think I'll be getting the other ones, though. When we go to the Queen's Ink that Saturday, you guys are in Maryland. I know, Jean. That's why I overlapped her, because I didn't know she was on. I should have looked, I guess, just to make sure, but I didn't. You know, I'm not that smart. I mean, let's be honest. Oh, that's a nice ghost. Ooh, I like that. You can see some, it almost looks watercolory up here. Can you guys see that? That's a nice print. I like you. I loved you. Oh, and look at this. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to get some more of those colors. I was going to get a black, too, but I didn't. I got these at scrapbook.com. They were on sale for $3.99 recently, and I think free shipping. Not much came off of there. But look how pretty my stencil looks now. Oh, yeah. Hello, lover. That's cool. Just so you know, I will not be eating the rest of the month of July. Jean's not going to. She's going to starve herself so she can have a free-for-all shopping in Maryland. Well, I can't say I blame you, honestly. I might be doing the same. Well, not for Maryland, but for when I go away. But I'm not planning on going away any... Well, Dave and I are going on a cruise, our honeymoon trip, finally. After many moons. Just trying to drag some different stencil patterns out here. All right, you know, I'm going to do a cleanup print just to get this, well, cleaned up. I'm just going to use some white. I'm not going to dirty up two brayers. So we'll see how much this blends off the plate when I put white on there, right? Squeakity, squeak, squeak, squeak. Yeesh. Yeah, $3.99, I thought that was a pretty good price, and so I just grabbed a few of those. Yeah, you can see how this is no longer stark white. It's blending with all those colors. See how it's picked up that pink down the bottom? But that's okay. Doesn't make it bad. Just makes it what it is. It's blendy. All right. I'm going to pick this up on Deli. See all those streaks through that paper? That's from the edge of my brayer cutting into the paint. I think they do, Sandy, come pre-squeaked. Matte medium for the cleanup. Really? That's a good idea. Hey, Colleen. Colleen, you're another Canada girl coming in for into Maryland. So I don't know if you were on here earlier when I made the offer about picking up the 1,000 sheets of Deli. It's $15.98 a box, and I can get free shipping here in the U.S. If you want to PayPal me the money to do that, I'll order you a box and then bring it over to the Maritime Museum when we meet. But again, I'm just doing that for the Canada girls, since they can't get deli paper on Mars. That's the craziest thing. Look, see how much of that came up off of there? And there's still all this paint on there. So what am I gonna do with you? I guess I'll make another one. That would have probably looked cool picked up on black. Oh, that's ridiculous. $17 plus $9 shipping for that little one. Are you CB Lisha? I'm sorry, I don't know your name, hub. Are you in Canada? Oh, good, Colleen. Now I'm getting some turquoise from this end. You think the plate's clean, but it's really not. Stubborn though to get all this up. Wants to fight me. Trying to get this cleaned off a little bit. So I'm gonna switch and do oh, Cindy, thanks, Jean. Okay, Paige, we'll have to, you know what, I should probably talk to Paula and see if there's anything she can think of that, I mean, I guess you could do, Paige is being really sweet and generous. She wants to donate something to the Maryland event, even though she can't make it with us, which I think is very sweet and generous. Everybody's pretty much bringing their own supplies, but you know what? If you wanted to, maybe, let's see, it's going to be 22 people that might go up to a possible 24. I have two more people interested if we can align that and make the room shareable. And that includes Paula and I. So, I don't have my calculator. Let's see. 15... 300, two, maybe two or three reams of that 110-pound white cardstock from Staples. But you know what? Don't pay for the shipping to get it to me. Like I said before, if you PayPal me the money, I'll buy it on your behalf and take it over to the girls when I go there. But that's a thought. And I think it's like $12 a ream. So if you want to do one ream or whatever, that's whatever you want to do is fine. I just think it's wonderful that you're wanting to help out like that. I'm going to get rid of this. The old-fashioned way. This goes against my grain to wipe off my jelly plate and not do another cleanup print, but I'm limited for time and I'll just have to suck it up and get used to it. But these plates are so blendable, and Dina's maybe too. I'm almost kind of hoping they are, because that's really fun when you get that blend. But we shall see. Okay. I'm going to put my lids on my Dylusions paints for the moment. They're known to dry out quickly, so I will put them on now since I'm going to switch up. I might go back to them later, depending on my time. But I'm really liking these paints so far. A little goes a long way, and it's so smooth. It's very luscious. All right. So here's a couple we got that are halfway decent. Out of the Dylusions, right? And there's some other ones too, but they, you know, wasn't wild about how they came out. Here's a third one of this, but this one wasn't much of a success, I don't think. But I'm not throwing them away because we haven't hit Papa Black time, so still got this one that's still a little wet on there. All right, so I'm going to put these aside. keep them up in another pile. I'm going to have a craft-a-lanch tonight. I can feel it in my bones. All right, lay this one on top so that dries. Maybe get those out of my way. Okay, let's switch. Oh, I got green everywhere. Oh, well, that's okay. That's okay. Let me drag some of my Dinas up here. I have needles on some of them, needle tips, but I can just take that off and squeeze it on my plate. So, let's see. Red. I really like her ruby red. It's a real vibrant red. Orange, blue, lime. All right, let's do a little turquoise. Patty, was that pink paint goopy like Zondra's? The Dylusions. I didn't see that Zondra had a problem. I must have missed that. But no, it's not. It's no different than the other ones that I can tell. Now, I will tell you that the pink paint leaked in my package, and I had pink paint on all my jars. And I called scrapbook.com, and they sent out a completely new one that did not leak. But that's the only issue I've had with the pink. Good night, Joan. I know it's late for you, dear. Glad you could pop in for a little bit. All right, a little turquoise. And what are we going to put on here? Let's do a little lime. And just a schmutz of lapis to get something dark in there. Break it up a little bit. And I'm going to my big brayer. Hitting the big boy. You know, I should try to blend them. I'll do that on the next one. Just to see. I'm going to save this. Actually, I like that. Just to see what I get. Okay. Give me a stencil. This is one of the Infinity stencils. This is a Shield Infinity. All right, and let's pick this up. Oh, and make sure a small color swatch didn't go all covered up by my messy painty fingers. You spritz water in your jelly plates, Indy? This is a speedball. They were both speedball brayers. Yep, they're both speedballs. Ooh, that's pretty. That little bit of lapis that I put in there really put a lot of depth in it. Look at that. That's added a lot of interest. If I don't get much of a ghost on these, I'm just going to pick up the ghost on Deli going forward. Ooh! No, that's not a bad ghost. Oh my god, I know. Drives you crazy. I actually get, you know, it's one of those things, I guess I just get used to it. Yeah, the Ranger brayers with that metal handle and the red roller that has the two legs that it can stand on. I don't care for those. I have a few of them. Different sizes, but I don't. The handle's squeezy, and sometimes I'm rolling it, and I'm rolling it hard enough, and the roller pops out because it pulls that handle that holds it together. Pulls that apart enough that I lose the brayer. Yeah, I don't like that. I like most Ranger stuff, but that I don't like. That's rather cool. I like these, all three of these prints that I got out of that. I do. So let's try, let me find my next stencil before I get too committed here with the I really got to organize these suckers because I'm telling you. Oh, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do poppies. But I tell you what I'm going to do, how I'm going to do it. I'm going to start out with some red. And I'm going to hold it this way so I can blend the way I want to. And then I'm going to put a little yellow. Now I'm going to go yellow down here. This might be a total reject of a print, but I'm going to try something. Try to get my red blend up here for the poppy pods. And then I'm going to go with some, a little bit of green down here where the stems are going to be. And a little bit of sky. So if the sky mixes with the yellow, it's just going to turn green. But it won't be, I don't know, it seemed like a good idea. I'm not sure why. All right, so I think, do I want the big brayer here? Yeah, I'll blend. I'll do this. Oh, maybe not. Yeah, that'll work. I can go this way. Get those two worked in together. All right. Clean that off. See how bright that is? Really bright, pretty red. Now let me get the yellow and back that up into the orange a little bit. Clean up that one. And I really got to get this red off of here or I'm going to get brown. Faux show. I don't know why I thought I had to put blue in there. That seems kind of silly now that I did it, but oh well. Okay. Got a little rainbow thing going on there. Kind of cool. So, I'm going to put my poppies on here. That might look really cool, actually. Let's see what we get. These blended nicely, too, actually. I know. It's going to be interesting. Okay. Here we go. Oh, hello, lover. I like that. That's kind of cool. And there's not much at all for a ghost in here, but I'm going to clean the holes of this with Gelli and ghost the Gelli. Because that's kind of easy to get down there to clean that little bit out. And this way, I'll try to get a clean print on the reverse of this stencil. You can see every little line on this Gelli. There you go. Got a little ghost on there. It's the kind of ghost I'm not afraid of. So let's do this. And let's pick you up on there. And you know what? I'm even going to take another piece and make a sandwich in case this comes off really cool. All right? And then I'll capture this on a separate piece of paper. And I'll have to decide if I want to use the front or the back. It's just a shadow. Oh, look at my stencil. So here's just a shadow of that reverse print. That's kind of cool though. I like it. I'm not hating that. Oh, that was a good pull. That pulled. You can tell when you curl your cardstock and hear it going, sucking off of there, that you got a pretty good cleanup pull. A little rainbow poppy action. I kind of like it. So, let's see. What do I want to do? Here's one. I haven't used this for a while. Let's try this one. What do I want to use? What do I want to use? White, green, orange. Let's use some magenta. And some yellow. And yeah, I'm gonna go wild and I'm gonna go turquoise here so we blend down. We kind of got primary colors ish, right? Okay, let's start here and get just turquoise down. I'm going to blend into grabbing some yellow and moving up against the pink, but trying not to grab the pink, but I got a little bit of pink, and bring that down and get my green. Ooh, look at you. These are both really nicely blendy. Blendy blendies. The Dylusions and the Dinas. Squeakity squeaking friggin' squeak. Now, I don't want to overlap too much and get the three of them overlapping there so I get baby poop. Alright, let's try this little lovely. See what we come up with. This one can be a little tricky because those holes are little to get it on cardstock because you got to really... I just want to try different ones, Bunny. I want to compare them how they work and how they feel on the jelly plate. Just new paints that I got. I'm trying to play with different ways and see how they compare or differ so I understand more how to use them. So when you have a stencil that has these little fine holes in it and you're using cardstock, this is 110-pound cardstock, you got to really convince that paper to go down and kiss that paint off the plate. And you got to push it through the depth of the Mylar, if that makes any sense, right? You guys know what I'm talking about. I'm not talking to a bunch of rookies. Hey, Annabelle. All right. Pushed on that one enough. Ooh. Hello, lover. Look at that blend. See if I can get it on here with some light. I really need to do something about these lights. From that hot pink down to orange, coral, yellow, different shades of green. Down into the turquoise, different blue greens, to that stark turquoise down the bottom. Oh, look at you. I am loving these. All right, I'm going to ghost this on Deli again because, as you can see, that Deli's so thin. See how you can see every little piece of that design coming up through there as you touch it? It's so much easier to use Deli on these thin designs than it is, especially cardstock. And the thicker the paper, the harder it is to get them down in there. You can do it, but it takes some convincing. Here's a little shadow, but I got the whole thing. Groovy. And now this ought to be pretty interesting. Oh, look at that. Ooh, little rainbow. And I'm going to do a sandwich again so I can get this on a different piece of paper to try to grab all that goodness. Yeah. Ooh. Oop. Oh, that's just the paper moving. Didn't slip the stencil. Oh, but look, I just got the outside of that because that's all I got was the frame of that. But that's okay. Let's see what I got here. Fun little background. All right. Let's see if I can get a little bit of this excess up. And the only reason I'm doing this, you guys have seen me jelly plate many, many times. And I like that crust to build up usually. Hey, Paula. I got the itch to come down here and try out my Dylusions paints on my jelly plate when you mentioned that the other day, thinking that I did the Dylusions when I did the Dina paints. And now I'm actually, now I am jelly plating with Dina paints right now, Paula. Because I switched up. Just cleaning that up a little bit. Okay, so these are a couple of the blends that I did. They're blending really cool on the plate, Paula. Here's some of the blends that I did. These are Dina's. This one's Dina's. I didn't blend, I just put three different colors of paint on there. Right? So, let's see. What do I want to do? I'm going to do another Dina. I want to do something red. I guess we're going to have to go red and orange. Red and yellow, maybe. No, red and orange. So this is what I've been doing. I've been kind of striping the paint. Red, orange, and hot pink. Let's see what we get there. I don't know if I'll get much contrast there or not, but I'm going to do it anyway. Okay. So, I've been just braying back and forth. That red, I love this ruby. I really like that red. I guess it's more of a blue red, but it's a true red. True blue. True blue red. This is why I don't name paint colors. Let me get that off of there. So I can get some of this pink to happen down here. Squeakity squeak. The squeak's getting worse, isn't it? Sweet Lord. That's going to be a subtle blend, but it's there. Let's do... Oh, I want another big one. Where's my big ones? I'm going to go back to this pyramid one. Hey, Paula, while you're here, Paige is here, and she wants to donate to the cause for, since she can't be there, she just wants to try to contribute something. So I was suggesting maybe some cardstock, but from your project, is there something that would be awkward for everybody to have to carry or heavy that maybe that would be an idea for Paige that you can think of? Hey, Debbie. Ooh. Woohoo. That's subtle, but it's really kind of cool. You can see from going red and then getting into the orange. And then, bam, hot pink. I'm just going to take the same piece of deli and try to pick up some of this. I can see I got a lot of the red down here. I don't know if I used more red or why it maybe didn't push as much down there. I don't know. All right. Get some of this out. kind of getting a hot color on there. This one I try not to rub too much because it's easy to pick up on those little, you know, and pull it and bend it. It's hard to tear, but you can bend it so it doesn't cooperate as much after you bend it and bend it and bend it. Ooh, 3D. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. All right. All right, what do I want to do? What do I want to do? I was thinking about putting stripes over these. Take care, Robin. Thanks for joining. I don't know. I haven't gone to my Papa Black stage yet. I'm going to try one more. I'm going to do something dark with Dina's darker colors here. Where's night? Where's my night? There it is. But you know what I'm going to do? I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to wipe this off again. Get rid of these because these paints are so blendy, Paula, that I've been wiping down my plate after I get a little buildup on there because it will color the next layer going down. And when you go hot and cold, pretty soon everything you're rolling out is baby poop. And if I wanted baby poop paint, I would buy baby poop paint. Okay. Okay, what do I want to do here? Night and what? Night and sky and just blend them one way to the other. One end to the other, maybe. Oh, I know. Let's do one of the gradient pulls that I used to do way back in the day when I first got my plate and one of my old YouTube videos of a gradient print. I left it kind of wet. I'm out of paper towel. Oh, no, I don't. I found some right here. Silly girl. Baby wipe left. It was a juicy baby wipe. Okay. And this might be too dark. Will that work? Eh, what the hell? We'll try it. So I'm going to put a little bit of the darkest. This is night down here. I'm going to put a little bit of the... No. Turquoise. Little bit of turquoise. And then... I haven't used my copper penny yet, but I'm going to use it now. It's got a little copper. That's not the artist. That's the paint tube making that noise. That's the way rumors start. Okay. Oop! Sheesh! Crap! That's what I get for being smart. Smarty pants. Yeah, save most of it. Get rid of that. Make sure I get all this red off of here. Okay, so I'm going to try to go diagonal. All right, get that going there. And then I'm going to come up and meet some... Oh, I should have brayered off. Should have brayered off. Squeakity, squeak and squeak fire. That's all right. I still got a little bit of a blend going there. Let's do some metallic up here in the corner. All right, let's see what we get. What am I going to use? Give me a stencil quick. I swear I really have to do something with these stencils. This one's pretty open. I wanted to get something open so you can really see a lot of the color. All right. Completely different. Time is it 7 o'clock? Okay, I'm gonna try to wrap up at 7:30, so we haven't had dinner yet. Dave said, "Go ahead and stream if you want to for a couple hours. We'll just eat later." Bless his heart. Okay, let's see what we get here with this gradient deal. Ooh, that's kind of cool. It's 3D-ish looking at all. And let me get my ghost on a piece of deli here. Little ghosty on my deli. And let's see what I can get off of the plate here. Paula Minky is my friend Joan from the UK that sent me all that cool scrapbook paper she makes using some of my art images in there and some of her own work and prints them out. I showed them on my last stream. That's Joan. Minky Joan. All right, a little cleanup on my stencil. That's kind of cool. Me likey. Okay, so now I think what I'm gonna do, and I'm just do this for Paula's benefit so you can kind of see how these Dylusions paints go down here, Paula. I'm gonna wipe this off again, and then after I do that, I'm gonna do a little pop of black on some of these puppies. And while I got black on the plate, I'll pull a couple patinas and color a night. And you can really still see shadows on this plate. So cool how it holds all that. I know, isn't Joan's stuff fabulous that she made me? And I can't use that computer program because I don't have a Mac. Actually, I could probably put it on my work computer. Hey, Erica. I could probably put that on my work computer. I wonder if I could, if my firewall will let me download it. I don't know. Okay. So, which blends did I really like on this? Oh, yeah. This one came out really cool, Paula, where I did the blend of the pink and the turquoise. It did. So what I was doing was I saw a video the other day, Carolyn Doobie. You know what? Now that you guys ask me about that pink, this is sticking to the sides a little bit thicker than the turquoise is. So maybe there is something to it with that pink stuff. But she dips her roller right in the jar. Of course, it's a little roller, and that's going to cause you to roll and roll and squeak to get the thing covered. But it is kind of handy not to have to dip it out with a palette knife or whatever. And this paint does go a long way on the plates, Paula. It really do. I'm going to make one more of my favorite blend here. Pick up some turquoise. Put that down on this side. Oops, get on the plate there. Little smidge more on that side of my brush, or my brayer. That's not a brush. And watch this fabuloso purple I get. But it does take a lot of rolling. But, I mean, you are blending paint right there on the plate. How cool is that? So let's see. I'll use a different stencil for that. Ooh, here's a good one. Here's an oldie but a goodie. Orbits. I like this design. It's kind of got a peace sign in there, which I didn't see at first when I made it. Calypso Teal, Erica, is that a, is that one of Diane's sprays, or is that a, Lindy's spray? That name sounds familiar. Okay, here we go. Let's see what kind of fabulous blend. Hello, lover. There's a lot of paint on there. Can you see the paint puckered? Too much paint. Too much paint. Rookie mistake. I'll try to get a ghost on here, though. There's enough on there for a decent ghost. I'm trying to get that thumb knuckle pushing down in those circular designs. Again, to try to get that thick cardstock down in the holes. Alright, let's see what we got. Oh! Hello. I really like when the teal and the purple, I mean the purple, how it goes into the teal and the colors that you get there. All right. So let me pick up the reverse. Look at that. Ah, this is not coming out on camera as hot colors as they are. They are really, really vibrant. And I'm gonna make another sandwich because this might be a decent enough print to keep on its hold on its own instead of throwing it on the back of something. But we are gonna make double-sided prints in Maryland for our journals. All right. Can't win them all. It's not fabulous, but it's there. That's a little more fabulous. Oh, are they, Jane? Good. Good. I'm glad they're showing up vibrant because they are hot, 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 hot colors. All right. Let's get a little... let's get a little papa going. Because I'm a quarter after seven. I might even have to cut short on the papa, but we'll do a couple. We will do a couple papas. All right, that's enough for now of that. So let's see, I'm gonna do some pops and iron gates, and guess what? This is gonna be a shocker. Pictographs. Patty, can I make do for your class if I just take my small round and cut up my Oh yeah, Jean. Yeah. You can, and you might not want to cover the whole page anyway to put it in your book. It's completely up, you know, up to you guys. We're gonna take these size papers and we're gonna fold them in half to make a page right in a book, right? So a couple prints on your 8-inch jelly plate would be enough to almost cover that. Yeah, you won't need the bigger one. It's just going to take more time to print your fabric for the cover, because you're going to print like a fat quarter, almost a fat quarter. Don't have to use the whole thing to print it, but that, I mean, it's just a matter of, you can use any plate to print that. You can use your small little stamp one and stamp all over it if you want to. Okay, hang on here, get some black, and, whoop, boogers, paint boogers, Yep, this one's. All right. Let's get a couple of these popped with some black. Let's see here. Let's take this stark one here. And let's hear Babe up there barking. Mojo got his staples out yesterday. Yay, no more cone of shame. Oh yeah, Paul, everybody can share everything. Lord knows I got plenty of stuff here I can take over if we need it. We'll have to have a Saturday night after the shopping spree. We'll have to come back and have dinner, go down to the room, and everybody show and tell what they bought and play with it or demo and do the paint marbling demo. I think that was Jane that wanted to do that. And, you know, just have some fun free time. Ooh, look at that. That's cool. There's my bubbies. Mojo. Hi, what are you doing down here? Daddy taking you outside? Huh? Go with Daddy. Go easy. Go easy. That's pretty cool. Right? Me likey that. Let's try a little bit of that over this. See if I can get enough of a ghost on this to make it print. Lucy, don't worry about buying glossy accents if you don't have it. You literally need a drop, and I'll have mine there. Well, got on part of it anyway. So I'm going to take, so now I'm going to go patina print, right? You guys know my patina print? I'm going to take a piece of deli, and I'm really going to try to clean out all these holes and get that design really stark and cleaned out. I'm using deli because that goes in the holes really easy. See there, you can see all, everything right through that stencil. That's not cleaning out, but I think that's almost dry there. I got a little bit of it. And the reason I want to do this is because I want this design, that open design, all right, let me be mindful of what I'm doing here so I don't screw up my stencil. I'm going to put this over here and clean off the back of the stencil and get that out of my way. And then I'm going to take a couple PBO paints. And for this, my favorites are green, blue, and yellow. Yellow, green, green, yellow. Green, yellow, and green, blue. So I'm going to put this on top of this black that's still wet. A little bit here and there. Get on there. All right, that ought to do it. And I'm going to spread those out. That blue looks so cool when it hits the back of that black. It really flashes that different color in there. Right, spread that on top of the black, brayer off, and then I'm going to just let the weight of the brayer roll across the page and pick up some of that extra PBO on there. See how the black's being exposed again. You can see the design more clearly that filled in, right? And then I'm going to pick that up. That's a good boy, Mojo. That's a good boy. I'll be up in just a few minutes, babe. I'm going to wrap up a couple more black prints here and then I'll be up. Hey, Rain. How are you?
I'm pretty good. How about you?
And I'm really pushing this one because this is going to be a cleanup print. I want it to suck all that paint up off my plate. So I'm hitting all the edges. So a lot of those crusty bits hang out there, right? You can peek. It's pretty good. You will leave some on the plate. It's not going to clean it up all the way because we left the paint on the plate a little wet. If you want to do a cleanup print, you want your paint on the plate dry. That's hard to say. Good thing I don't have dentures. I have to spin them across the room. I can't believe how much pink this picked up. And you guys might not be able to see it. That's what I call a patina print. There's a lot of pink up and through here. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. Okay, one patina down. So now I'm going to go back to black again. And I'm just going to do a couple papas on a couple more prints and I'm going to wrap it up. Which I feel like I'm just getting on a roll. Now I'm sorry, I said it'd only be a little while. Not that I don't love my husband. Alright, oops. Knotted that up pretty good. That's a hot mess. Let me get that out of my way before I hurt somebody. Okay, so now let's go pictographs. Let me some pictographs. That's always a good pop of black. So let's see. What do I want to put those on? Do I want to put them on there? I don't know. Maybe this for some reason. I don't know. That's calling to me. I think the Iron Gate and the pictograph, they're my two favorite patina prints to do. Oh, you know what? I wonder what a poppy patina print would look like. Ho-ho! And use the red, blue, and the violet colors, maybe? I'm going to do that. So now I've got to find something I want to put the black poppies on. That would be kind of cool, though, in anything, really. All right, a little pop of pictograph. You can't hate that. You just can't hate that. So I'm going to, since I'm in kind of a hurry, I'm going to do this with Gelli. Pick up all the paint in those pictograph holes to clean those out and make room for the other colors I want to put in there. Right. Get most of that off of there. And that kind of makes it, see how you can see through there now? Where it's all, those holes are empty. I'm going to pull this, print that on here. Now, I didn't use a lot of paint and it's pulling all this up. So that's not going to come out exactly the way I want it to, but oh well. Is there anything exact and perfect in this world? No. All right, let's try this. I like these when I have more black paint and it comes out more stark. Let me do one on Gelli. Because this looks really cool in collage when you take a little bit of this patina print and collage. Let's hope so, Joan. Give that a really good schmutz. Hard to hold this deli, it's so fine to hold it up to give it any structure. But there you go. Little patina pictographs. And now I'm gonna do, let me find a print that I want to put the patina, I mean the black poppies on. I might use this one. I want something really graphic and stark. That's too dull, I think. Maybe that. I don't know. Let me see what my other prints are over here. Some of these are just junk prints. Well, they're junk now, but I'll fix them. Maybe on that reverse one. That would be a lot of color in the background. Perhaps. Ooh. There's that other pink and turquoise that made that purple. Oh, maybe even on that. Okay, let me decide from these. Not on a patina print. We're not going to do that. Let's see. So what would look the coolest with a black poppy over it? For some reason, I'm feeling this one. What I'm gonna do. Let's not make it a big decision, people. Let's just start throwing some paint down. Get her done. So I'm gonna put a little bit more black on this one so I get a darker patina print, and I'll show you the difference because some of that looks grayed out. I'm not wild about those, honestly. A little more black. Poppies, where are my poppies? And watch, I won't be able to find the damn stencil before it all gets crusted up on me. Oh, here we go. Oh, I fibbed. I got it. Here's my print from earlier. The rainbow colors are still on there. All right, let's get a little, some black poppies on this. Here we go. No turning back now, people. I mean, what if it screws up? Ooh. A piece of paper. I'll just do another one. Hey, Darcy. It's a thought. Hey. I'm trying an experiment here now. Oh, I didn't see what you said, Jean. I was watching the clock and think I better just go for it here and just get her done. All right, let's see what happens here with these stark black poppies, like a silhouette kind of a look, right? A little too much paint, but I wanted more paint so the patina print came out right. That's kind of cool. These look like they have little bulbs growing out of them. Look how all three of those hit right at the top where those little balls are. Hey, Dorothy. All right. Okay, I got a lot of paint here. I want to put this on something else. Let's do it on this one. I don't know if that's the one you said or not, Jean, but that's where we're going. This should be a pretty decent ghost because there was all... Hey, Di. All right, see what happens here. See, I think I was right to go with this one. See how much more it pops against that, some of that white space back there? And this one's just up against the paint, and it's not It's not, of course, it's a different background design too. But this is more full of paint on the background, this one is. It's so funny how those balls came out right on top of the poppies. Okay, so for my last trick of the day, I'm gonna get the holes of the poppies cleaned out here on some deli, and I'm gonna do a patina print of poppies. My crazy palm tree poppies. Oh, look. Got a pretty good ghost of that over top of the pictographs. So, now do I want to use my standard colors or do I want to mix it up? Let's go crazy. Oh, I could do the orange. Let's see. What is this? This is orange yellow. And then there's violet blue, pink and blue, orange and yellow. Or the red is red and blue, orange and yellow. They could all make mud, but honestly, on a patina print, that only makes it look more like metal. So I'm not worried about the mud thing for this. But I'm going to flip this over, clean off the back of my stencil. There's a lot more black paint down here, which is what I wanted. Oops. Yeah. Okay. And now I'm going to go with some red blue. And some orange yellow. Oop. Get out of there, orange yellow. And I'm trying not to rub and smear up the design on the plate and the black paint. So, here we go. Over the river and through the woods. Why the hell did I say that? Now I want turkey. Okay, now I'm going to go over. Oops, I got a hot mess going on here. I want to go over this with just the weight of the brayer to pick some of this extra. See, there's so much on there, it's not even going to roll. There we go. And reveal that where the design, the paint, the PBOs are in the holes of the stencil there that we cleaned out, right? Just the weight of the brayer here. I'm not pushing on it. Just letting it pick up a little bit of that excess paint that's, oh, damn, that schmutzed it. See? You know, just sometimes just let it do what it wants to do. Instead of screwing with it. So here we go. But the back side of this is not what you're going to see. You're going to see what's on the bottom of the jelly plate, right? Because this, what I just schmutzed there, is sticking to the back of this paper. So, all right. Did it work? Or was it a flub? All right. Let's see what we got. Oh. Hello, lover. That's kind of cool. It's picking up a little of that green gold off on the sides here, almost like a background from the previous patina prints that I did. So there you go. One patina, two patina, three patina, more. There you go. That's what I got. So I am going to go upstairs and eat with my husband. So I kind of like those, but see how that turned purple with the blue and the red in there? You get really crazy results. But see what I mean? How this is kind of gray in the background and not as black as this one is. It's because there was less paint. I got just a sheer wash of the paint coming up off of that. And this one as well. This one isn't black. That's more, I don't know, kind of see-through-y gray. But, so let me show you a couple of the things that we did here before I go, for the ones who just came in, I was playing with Dina Wakely paints on the plate, and I was playing with Dylusions paints on my jelly plate. And I really found them both to be very blendable. The Dylusion paints go a long way. They go longer than the Dina's do, because hers are heavy body, right? And the Dylusions are more loose. They're very creamy. So let's see what I got here. So these are some of the Dina prints that I did. I did this one with Night Turquoise and her Penny copper one, right? Did kind of a gradient pull through that. I blended out the poppies and got that pull with her paints. And then I just had three colors on the plate. I had the turquoise, the lime, and the night to get that. This was the reverse pickup from the, I have the good one somewhere. We'll get to it. But that was Dina. These were Dylusions. The pink and the turquoise blended to get the purple in the middle. This is a reverse pickup of the one that I printed the poppies on. Here's the ghost of the one of Dina's with the pictographs on it. Right? And this one was the reverse stencil of the that same pole with a little bit of iron gate on there. This one's cool. This was Dina's paints. That was her ruby and a little orange and hot pink. And that I did kind of a blend over that. And that's iron gate on top of those. Let's see. What else? Some of these are just wiping off the back of the stencil, so there's nothing, you know, to write home about with these. Some of these. Here's just my cleanup. I was cleaning up my little brayer as I was doing the Dylusions paints. This was just a blend that I never went back and did anything on top of these. But these are Dylusions. Here's the Greek key. The turquoise and the pink made the purple in the middle. Here's the ghost of the Greek key, which is like a perfect pull. I got every little bit of that stencil on that one, and that came out really cool. This one's kind of graphic, just the stripe stencil and then the chevrons. Did yellow and turquoise on the chevrons, and I did, I think, yellow and hot pink on the stripes when I did those pulls. Yeah, that one didn't come out so great. It kind of blended too much. Here's another blend of the stripes and the arrows. These are all the Dina paints. This, I don't like how that blended. That was not a wise pull. Neither was this one, neither was this one. Here's the reverse, the Greek key, right? And that's where we were. So, yeah, I'll post some pictures, and thanks for joining me. I mean, talk about last minute. I have about a 10-minute warning to myself that I was going to get on tonight. So, I suppose I'll catch you guys tomorrow on Paula's stream. And until then, go make some fun jelly prints. Thanks, guys. Thanks for joining. Time for supper. I think my husband's grilling something. Gotta love that guy. Toodles.